our Kubernetes nodes at your pods are not healthy and not ready to receive any traffic. How your application communicates with Kubernetes to tell it when something goes wrong. And how you can use Kubernetes to make sure that anytime something goes wrong, you can guard your users and application. The short answer is probs, and if you want to be experts in probs, you need to watch this two-part tutorial. Let's go. What does it mean that a pod is ready? It means that this pod is ready to do its job and it's in a perfect condition. So Kubernetes knows that it can send traffic to it. But how Kubernetes marked this pod as ready? In pod, we got multiple containers. Only when all the containers are in ready state, then the pod can be marked as ready. It's like your computer when you try to start it up. The CPU, the hard drive, the screen, everything must be ready in order for it to work. How can you know that your pod is ready? You can do kubectl get pod, you will see the ready column, and you will see how many containers out of how many containers are ready in this particular pod. So for example, if you got 2 out of 2, it means that 2 containers are ready out of 2 containers. And if you got 0 out of 1, it means that the only container that you got in this pod is not ready. At this point, you must ask yourself, but how Kubernetes knows if my containers are ready or not? So the answer is that your containers need to tell Kubernetes if they are ready or not. How does it work? Kubernetes continuously going to ask our containers if they are ready. How? For example, a specific endpoint or a TCP connection, we configure what the question is going to be, and in our code we need to add a code to actually reply or respond to it. So for example, we define a health configuration, and Kubernetes continually going to ask this endpoint if it's ready or not, and based on the response, it's going to act. If it's 200 okay respond, everything is fine. If it's any other HTTP code, Kubernetes is going to mark this container as not ready. So basically, when we are talking about probes and readiness probes, we have a lot of configuration that we can control. Like, what is the protocol that we want Kubelet to ask the containers if they are ready or not? It can be HTTP. What is the path for the HTTP request? What is the timeout? And we got like a lot of configuration that you can control what it means ready or not for you. It's very useful because it gives a lot of flexibility around the ready status and the ready configuration. So why is that so important to use readiness prob in order to reflect your application status? So the first thing is obviously reliability. Because when we are using Kubernetes automations and actually reflect our application status, Kubernetes helps us to be more reliable. The second thing is about monitoring and observability. Obviously, when all of your pods are not ready, then something wrong with your application. First of all, you want to get alert on it and act as fast as you can. And second thing, when you look in your observability dashboard and you see that all of the pods are down for one specific deployment, it means that you immediately need to actually find out what's wrong with it. So it benefits us on both reliability, to guard us when things go wrong, and also to help us find them faster. But what are the common mistakes when configuring readiness probes? So first of all, there are some people that do not configure those. Do not configure them in the manifest, but also do not code it in their applications. It's a terrible mistake. You want to make sure that you have some readiness probe in any one of your pods or your deployments. The second thing, which is very common, is to not fail when underlying infrastructure failed. So for example, you have your application and it relies on a connection to database. And when the database is down, your application cannot do its work. So please fail in your readiness probe anytime your underlying database or queue or whatever service that you're using failed. I would say this is the top common mistake. Make sure that you first of all configure, code it, and make it proper reflection of your application status. So now you are like readiness probes experts. In this next video, I'm going to explain more about liveness probe and also startup probes, which actually completes the world of probes in Kubernetes. Stay tuned, and if you like this video, please like, subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much.